based on the issues and the things that were going on around Indiana, I wanted to correct some assumptions. We had heard that the pizza, the first news that came out about the pizza parlor's statement was that they say they're not going to cater gay weddings. They're the first business in Indiana to deny the, you know, the gays.
It was said that
pizza.
They would deny service to gays. The
yes.
First one to deny service to gays.
Right. And what happened is people reacted to that initial story until they figured out what happened and went back and I believe on PJ Media and on Ace of Spades, they went back and walked through the progression of what had happened. And it was a completely different story. A reporter went shopping for a reaction in, you know, small towns, if you know what I'm saying. And I really wanted to take some misconceptions that conservatives might have had about how this all works and show how the media can create a story and some tactics that the media did. So I wrote a piece. It was Basics of Media Bias. And then as soon as I had written it, not the same day that I had it published, the Rolling Stone report from the Columbia School of Journalism came out about the story they did last year on University of Virginia and the gang rape. So there was a ton of stuff to talk about there in media. And as a person who's been in front of the cameras, you know, talked to shows and people in the news before, you know, I felt like there was no one else saying those things. No one else was helping prepare conservatives to understand the media so that they could recognize when they were being played or being trolled or being, you know, that a story was being pushed, that there's a definite bias and you need to recognize it in order to be able to deal with it.
Was there anything that the pizza place could have done when, because we can't control what reporters are going to do, so reporters are going to try to make a name for themselves and go out and look for a story. We know that they are activists now. They're not reporting the news. They are activists creating a story. So they're going to do this, and they're going to show up at your little place of business, or they're going to ask you on the street, and they're going to have a microphone in front of you. Was there any way that the pizzeria owner could have avoided being in the middle of that? Was there anything she could have done differently?
I think the thing that we really need to talk about is, what are we expecting of this pizzeria owner? How many pizzeria owners get asked questions like this that are clearly meant to, you know, entrap people? It's ridiculous, the kind of media training. Like, that's something that would trip up a lot of people who are trained. So I don't know if there's anything that she could have that could have been done to prevent it, but it just proves, it goes out to show that people are trying to make news stories. These journalists are out there because they need to get clicks, they need to get views, and it's a really juicy story to have a Christian pizzeria turn away gays, even though that's not what happened.
But
well,
you can,
and I'll say,
get the clicks, yeah.
I'll say that the reason that I wrote this piece specifically was in response to a conservative who took the position that the pizza joint owners ought to have known better, than to talk to the press. And I
what
just
could
think
they have
there
known
was,
better? What could have they have said differently?
Well,
Todd Akin should have known better. Todd Akin should have known better than to speak to the press. There are so many examples of people who actually should have known better than to talk to the press and didn't, or said the wrong things. I mean, it's ridiculous. But we're talking about a mom-and-pop pizza shop in Indiana, so it's probably not even good pizza. So,
they might make good spaghetti. I don't know. They might make good spaghetti. I could see that at a wedding, although it's rather disastrous for a lot of clothes. But still.
But, you know, somebody comes up with a camera and a microphone to you and asks you a leading question about some story of the day, and maybe you haven't even read the news and you don't even know, but she's asking you a question. She looks nice. She seems nice. And you're having a busy day. And, okay, there's a reporter here. I'm going to get my store on the news. This will be great. So she's going to ask you a nice question, and you're going to have a nice little conversation with this nice lady. And then all of a sudden, holy crap. You know, I think that the conservative media, I think we responded quite well to this situation. It seems to me that we're learning. We responded quite well in tearing down the truth of the actual RFRA legislation. I think we responded really well in defending this pizzeria. It helped that the left overreacted so desperately. But we have some really good activists on our side that were able to get out quickly and squelch this and really kind of turn it into a win for freedom. Not a win for conservatism, but a win for freedom. Because a lot of people, I think, got that message.
If you talk about money and the price of things, when the other side is saying, if it just saves one life, it's worth whatever it costs.
Yeah, you're a bad person.
You're the bad guy.
Uh-huh. That works as military spending too, right?